Hello again, my fellow pilots and aircraft maintenance personnel from Cairo, Egypt. Your host is always Haisam Ali, and I'm an aviation technical instructor. This is a performance-related training session to change your behavior regarding aircraft maintenance and operational activities. I will push towards concrete and basic principles regarding our daily operation and maintenance activities. Our topic for today, I will showcase the principles of the minimum equipment list. I will show you six principles of the minimum equipment list that you need to take care about regarding aircraft maintenance and operational activities. So first, what is the minimum equipment list? The minimum equipment list is a basic dispatch document that we can use it in the daily basis of operation of the aircraft. Imagine that the aircraft suffers from a component malfunction or a system degrade or a system function degradation, and we are short of time and no spare part in the warehouse. So we need to dispatch the aircraft safely without compromise safety, and we need to take action regarding this malfunction of a component or a system. So, principle number one. The mother of the MEL is the master minimum equipment list. Master stands for the manufacturer. This means that the master minimum equipment list is produced by the aircraft manufacturer, and it is a general one. General. For all operators of this aircraft or for a specific type. And approved by the authority which the manufacturer is based on. Like, for example, if the manufacturer is Airbus or Boeing, so the master minimum equipment list will be approved by the EASA or the FAA. So this is a general MEL, which is called the master MEL or manufactured MEL. So, principle number two. The master minimum equipment list is the mother of the MEL. The MEL is a tailored MEL, which permit operation of the aircraft safely. If the aircraft suffer from system or system function degrade or component inoperative, the operator can use the MEL to dispatch the aircraft safely. So what is the relation of the MEL and the MEL? The MEL must be as restrictive as or more restrictive than the master minimum equipment list. So we can find here the MEL is as restrictive as or more restrictive than the master minimum equipment list. So what is the difference between the master minimum equipment list and the minimum equipment list? The MEL is a tailored one. And we can go to number three, principle number three. The MEL, minimum equipment list, is produced by the operator itself. We can call it is a tailored one and approved by the National Aviation Authority of the operator. Imagine this operator is Egypt Air. So Egypt Air country is Egypt, okay? So the MEL must be approved by the Egyptian Civil Aviation Authority, for example. So again, what is the difference between the master minimum equipment list and the MEL? I do say that it is a tailored MEL. Why? What is the meaning behind tailored? The operator can go through or can assess its operation on the master minimum equipment list, and can change some points or some facts to be more restrictive than the master minimum equipment list. So what is this point that the operator can tailor the master minimum equipment list on it? Its flight schedules, its environmental condition, its route, and its local regulation. Imagine that the Egyptian Civil Aviation Authority and the EASA having some different regard this regulation. So the MEL must be approved by the Egyptian Civil Aviation Authority. So in the MEL, we can tailor the master one regarding the regulations of the Egyptian Civil Aviation Authority. Imagine that the local operator has a harsh environmental condition. So a dispatch item condition must be more restrictive in a harsh environment. So this is the difference between the master minimum equipment list and the MEL. So we have discussed now principle number one, principle number two, and principle number three. What about principle number four? Principle number four, it is what is the function of the MEL? What we can say about the function of the MEL? The function of the minimum equipment list is to optimize aircraft dispatch reliability and profitability without impairing safety. This is the function of the MEL. We need to dispatch the aircraft, but there is a malfunction, a component malfunction, or a system degrade. So we need to take care regard safety. We need not to impair safety, and we need to take care about profitability. Imagine there is no spare part now in the warehouse or in the store regarding maintenance. So this is a conditions for dispatch. We need to dispatch the aircraft, but we need not to impair safety. So this is the function of the MEL. Again, to optimize aircraft dispatch reliability and the profitability without impairing safety. Principle number five. MEL, or minimum equipment list, which we can call it customized or tailored, to allow the operator assess impact on their operation. And I do discuss this principle. Again, MEL, to allow the operator assess impact on their operation. And this is the difference between the master minimum equipment list and the customized MEL. The MEL allows the operator to assess operations, its operation and its environmental condition, its local regulations on the master minimum equipment list, and the tailor its customized MEL. So again, the customized MEL must be as restrictive as or more restrictive than the master minimum equipment list. What about number six? MEL consists of items. Each item has conditions for dispatch. Imagine the aircraft has a malfunction, component not operate, system degrade, system function not operate. So we need to take action. We need to assess the situation if it is a go item or no go item or go if item. So the MEL is divided according to items or systems or messages, and we can take a decision like this. We can take a decision that this item is a go item, so we can dispatch without any conditions. No-go item, this malfunction or this degradation, we cannot dispatch the aircraft. It is unsafe to operate the aircraft unless we do the required maintenance. And condition number three, go if. What is the meaning about go if? We can dispatch the aircraft, but we need to take care about some operational conditions or maintenance conditions or both of them. This is the meaning behind principle number six, items. There is some action we need to take, conditions. We need to take care about the conditions for dispatch. It is maybe operational conditions or maintenance condition. So now we discuss six principles of the MEL. And before I finish, I need to tell you about these 2 points. Do we can use the MEL in flight? Do we can use the MEL in flight? As I told you, the minimum equipment list is a dispatch document. So its primary function or its primary function on ground before flight to assess if we can dispatch the aircraft or not. So let's imagine that the aircraft is flying now and the captain found a component malfunction or a system degrade. So can he consult his MEL in flight? No. The only benefit of the MEL in flight that the captain can speak with the maintenance control center or the dispatch, operator dispatch center, and tell them about this component degradation or system degradation. And while the aircraft is on flight, the maintenance control center or the dispatch center on ground can take action regarding the next flight. This is the benefit behind the MEL in flight. So it's a primary function on ground, but we can use it for assess the next flight dispatch condition if this problem happened in flight. Number two, what about multiple failures? Do we can consult the MEL if there is multiple failures or multiple component and system malfunctions? Yes, each component inoperative or each system malfunction or degrade. We can assess each item itself, but we need to take care about the compatibility between this number of failures. If there is a maintenance action or an operational action of one item that can do affect the other problem, we can take care, we need to take care about the compatibility of the failures that we do consult the MEL about. So this is my training session for today. I try to push toward some principles of the MEL. So thank you for your good listening. And now on the screen, you will have a training session. I do design it. If you take care about, or if you got a look about it, you will see some difference between the master minimum equipment list and the minimum equipment list. So please take a look and please share your thoughts with me if you are having any feedback or if you are having any concern about this training session. Please, I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Thank you for your good listening. And as I told you, always fly safely and maintain your aircraft very safely. And I will meet you very soon, my fellow airline pilots and aircraft maintenance personnel. Thank you again for your good listening and goodbye.